Okay, Psalms chapter 16. Michtam of David. Michtam is a prayer or meditation. You can see Psalms 56, 57, 58, 59, and 60. This is a remarkable psalm. It's a messianic psalm, means it's about the Messiah, and it's to rebuke some heresies. After all, let's let God be true and every man a liar. Preserve me. Now, preserve me is to keep or save from injury or destruction, to defend from evil. I've always heard, you know, preserve as, you know, take up preserves, you know, fruits and put them up. But there's a more that David's asking God to keep him from injury and from evil and for deliverance from God, from God's help to David. Preserve me, O God, in thee do I put my trust. That's who you trust to be. You know, it's funny that our money says in God we trust, and that's the biggest lie. You take the capital G and drop it down to a small g and add an S to it. But how many gods there are there in America? You know, God we trust, yeah. That's a true statement for America. But which God? Look in the old pages under churches and see how many gods. Oh my soul, the eternal part, thou hast said unto the Lord. You mean your soul talks to God? Thou art my Lord. Well, isn't that an interesting thing for, as we studied Tuesday night's eternal security, that the fact is, being saved, and this is an Old Testament saint, this is not a newborn Christian, born again. This is David. He says, listen, my soul cries unto thou art my Lord. Now, if David, Old Testament salvation, man can say that, what do you think your soul says to Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit indwelling in you? My goodness, you can't say that. Your goodness is Jesus Christ. Extendeth not to thee. I can't do all that you want me to do, God. So quote that verse to somebody who says, my works. My goodness extendeth not to thee, God. You know, it's funny, all the good that the Tower of Babel back there in Genesis, how big man thought it was, and God says, we're going to go down and look at that. The work of man there, God says, I got to go down and see it. But, to the saints. Now, saint in the Bible is not a dead man. He's a man that's alive. Only a false heresy church would teach dead saints. By the way, if you're a saint in the Bible, you're always living because no man dieth. We saw Paul, or heard Paul today say, to be absent from the body, be present with the Lord. There's never a dead saint unless you've got a dead religion. Because look what David says here, but to the saints that are in the earth. Well, there were saints in David's time that were in Abraham's bosom. There are saints today that are with the Lord Jesus Christ. And to the excellent, and whom is all my delight? It's God. Their sorrows, every man will have sorrows. Just because you're saved, just because you're of God, doesn't mean the end of sorrow. That fact means more. All they that live godly shall, in Christ Jesus, shall suffer persecution. We're going to be added. Their sorrows shall be multiplied that hasten after another God. Now this is a complete opposite. David says, listen, you're going to get worse if you turn to other gods, and that's an Old Testament thing. God will beat you. And listen, that's exactly what he did to Israel. That's exactly what he did to Judah. America's entering into sorrows because guess what? Hasten after another God. Hasten means quit. Let's go. They're out the door and halfway dressed. Listen, the stores are hastening. Hurry up and get Christmas. Hurry up and get Valentine's. Hurry up and get this holiday. Hurry up and get this. That's hasten. After another God. Their drink offerings of blood. Somebody offers drink offerings of blood? Genesis 9:4, Leviticus 17:10, Acts chapter 15, verse 20 says, you're not to drink blood. Before the law, under the law, and under grace. Somebody is offering blood as a drink. A Bloody Mary, I guess you would call it. Or saying that you're drinking the blood of a Jewish man. Or a Gentile man, according to the cover of a magazine. Their drink offerings of blood will I not offer. I'm not even going to suggest. Nor take up their names unto my lips. David's not even going to mention their names. You know, unless you're not a teacher, unless you're not a preacher, as a typical born-again Christian, you are not even mentioned the names of the gods. But in American society, the great Christian nation that we are, every time you name one of the 12 months, you're mentioning a god. You can't escape it today. The Lord is the portion of my inheritance. Now we're going to get into some meat now. If you want an inheritance, a lot of people want an inheritance, let it be the Lord. He's got a great inheritance. He's got everything. All the money, all the riches, and everything. Everything on this planet is going to be burnt up. And of my cup. Now here's a mention of a good cup. Usually a cup in the Bible is judgment. But here's a cup that's good, that fills with holiness. Be ye filled with the Spirit. This is what kind of cup this is. Thou maintainest my lot. And that lot, we're going to go through the next verses as we see inheritance. We're going to see an estate. It's the lot is what you get. The lot here is like casting lots. I get what's good, David's saying. So there's inheritance, there's a lot. The lines are fallen unto me in pleasant places. Now that's an interesting thing there. You just read that and say, oh, I read my Psalms, blah, 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 who cares? But you don't know what's there. I'll tell you what's there. Ever seen a map of the world? What do you see over that map? Called longitude and latitude. You see lines. You see boundary lines for states and countries. And there it is in your King James 1611 Bible, Psalm 16 verse 6 tells you that a map is to have lines. They're boundaries. And you know where those lines came from, and they came from God in His Word. And David says the lines are falling to me in pleasant places. Now if that boundary line that belongs to David is going to be a good place. Yea, I have a goodly heritage, that's its state. We have an inheritance, we have a lot, we have lines that have fallen, and we have an heritage. And Israel is going to get the land, they're going to get all. David's going to be the prince of it all in the millennium. They're going to get the new earth. I will bless the Lord. Isn't it funny how everybody wants God to bless them? God bless America. Why don't they ever say America bless God? Psalm 16 verse 7. You can bless the Lord. What does bless mean? You check out when Leah names her boys and all that. One of them is, I forget which one it is now, but it says bless. I think it's Gad, but I can't be sure. And she says, blessed be, and she says, happy. Yeah, you can make God happy. Or you can read Revelation 3, 15, and 16 and make God sick. Who has given me counsel? You're to go to the Lord and get your advice. Too bad Rehoboam never did that. My reins. Now that's your thoughts. That's your mind. You find that in Psalm 73:21, Jeremiah 12:2, 17:10, Revelation 2:23 about the rains. Also instruct me in the night seasons. You know what your thoughts are to be on? They're to be about God. When you can't sleep at night, you ought to be thinking about God. And you'll be asking God instruction. Maybe you can't sleep for a reason. Maybe God wants to deal with you. I've always said when you can't sleep, it's a time of prayer. And it's a time to say, God, what am I to do? How am I to do it? That's instruction. I have set the Lord always before me. Except for one time when you go for a walk on the porch. As David writes Psalm 16, he's always set the Lord before him. And David can say that only because the Lord knows the heart of David. God knows our heart. The motive of David's heart and life is God. Yeah, he sinned. We all sin. All come short of the glory of God. But in David's heart, he loved the Lord and wanted to do right. And yes, he sinned, so do we. Because he is at my right hand. Right hand symbols strength. I shall not be moved. You can also put that to the Lord Jesus Christ. I have set the Lord God, Jehovah, always before me. Jesus Christ did 100%. This is a messianic psalm. This is about Jesus Christ. So Jesus set the Lord always before him. Jesus Christ fulfilled the first commandment. I'm going to go back and maybe read according to Jesus. Now, because he is at my right hand, Jesus is at the right hand of God. But right there, he would be God, so it's David. God is not at Jesus' right hand. Jesus is at the right hand. David's going to be a prince, while Jesus is the king. I shall not be moved. David settled forever. The sure mercies of David. Therefore my heart is glad. Not his head, not his feelings, his heart was glad. And my glory rejoiced. My flesh also shall rest in hope. What do you mean by that, resurrection? David knows after he dies, he's not going to sit there in a grave. Even though Peter says in Acts chapter 2, you know David's sepulcher is here and his body's still there. It ain't going to be there one day. It's going to be walking around in the millennia in Jerusalem, sitting on a throne with Jesus Christ there. Now, can we stop there and just go home, pack it up? Do you want me to go on to the next verse? Or shall we just close up Psalm 16? I'll go load up on the computer what I need to load up to get the other program and carry us onto our way. Shall we do half the Bible or all the Bible? Lord willing, I want to do these family things, even if you children move on, it's just Tracy and I want to do these things every night that we can do possible. And Lord willing, I don't know how many days it would be, but if we get to Revelation 22, and, I mean, I don't know if we'll be living by then, but go back and start Genesis 1 again. So we're going to do the whole Bible. And I said in my mind the other day, I am not going to hit particular people. So I am not aiming this at particular people. If you teach this, well, you're guilty. I don't care who you are. Okay, ready? Messianic song. For thou will not leave my soul in hell. I got to ask you a question. David, it's a mention of David. Did David go to hell? Did David go to hell? No. He had the sure mercy that he should have gone to hell for adultery and for murder, but God said no. David was sitting in Abraham's bosom. He's in glory now. He's coming. You think if he was in hell, he'd be coming back as a prince? Would God allow somebody to come out of hell and be a prince of the nation? The answer is no. David's not in hell. So let's read on. Thou wilt not leave my soul in hell. Neither wilt thou suffer thy Holy One to see corruption. Jesus Christ, the Holy One of the Bible, and I've got tons of scripture to give, and I'm not going to give it. Arose from the grave 3 days and three nights. How many days was Lazarus in the tomb? 4 days. What did Martha say about the body? He's stinking. Jesus Christ never had the chance to stink. Because his body did not start to decompose. Never did. Never had the time. According to chapter 16, verse 10, can't be David because David didn't go to hell. So there's only one soul in the verse with the context is the Holy One. The body is in the grave, did not corrupt. The soul was not in the body when Jesus died. That's impossible. Because once you die, your soul departs. Even Jesus went into hell. And God did not leave him there. And he come out of hell and went into that incorruptible body and rose from the grave. That's scripture. I'm going to leave it just like that. I'm not going to add anything to it. Verse 11. Thou, God, will show me the path of life. In thy presence is fullness of joy. So we're going to be all in joy with God. There'll be no sadness, except for one time, at the great white throne judgment. I can't imagine how we're going to react when we first see Satan in heaven. I don't know how we're going to react for some of us who are afraid of heights and when we're in the clouds meeting with the brethren and we look down. I wonder how we're going to be. At thy right hand there are pleasures forevermore. Well, who's at the right hand of God? Jesus Christ. What is Jesus? Pleasures forevermore. Eternity. So as far as Jesus, verse 1, preserve me, O God, the prayer of Jesus. Keep him from the evil. Satan was after him all the days of his life. 33 and a half years Satan tried to kill him and get him. For in thee do I put my trust. Jesus trusting in God. O my soul, thou hast said unto the Lord. Jesus had a soul. Thou art my Lord. The soul of Jesus claimed God Jehovah. My goodness extends not to thee. Can't make that one. That's got to be David. Can't go all the way. Because Jesus was all goodness. But to the saints that are in the earth, and to the excellent in whom is all my delight. Well, Jesus lived and walked amongst the people, the saints. He had a lot of them following him, and they were his delight. He delighted in Nicodemus, even though he was a secret follower. You think he delighted in the Pharisees and all that? No. Their sorrow shall be multiplied that hasten after another God, while God was in the flesh. Their drink offerings of blood will I not offer. Christ will not offer drink offerings of blood. He said in John chapter 6, yeah, then he turned around and said, flesh and blood profiteth little, or not nothing, I forget which. Nor take up their names unto my lips. Besides Beelzebub, what name of any false god did Jesus ever name? Not one. Or if he's talking about the wicked ones who were offering blood, what name of a Pharisee, Sadducee, scribe did Jesus rebuke naming? Right, he rebuked all of them. You know, you scribes, you Pharisees, you hypocrites. The Lord is the portion of my inheritance. When Christ arose from the dead, look at the inheritance he got. Look at all what God told him in Galatians. He got it all. Everything and all. And of my cup, here's a good cup. Thou maintainest my lot. I get it all. I took the cup of sin, and now I get the cup of blessing, Jesus. The lions are falling onto me in pleasant places. All the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Yea, I have a goodly heritage and state. The new heavens, the new earth, new Jerusalem. All the millennial earth. Where there's only one thing that will be still under the curse. You know, there's only one thing that's under the curse in the millennium, and that's the snake. He still walks on his belly and eats dust. Isaiah, Ezekiel, one of those major prophets. I will bless the Lord. So he prays to the Father and gives the Father the credit. Who has given me counsel. Where did Jesus get all what he used to do and how to do it? He got it all from God. He didn't ask man one thing. They came to him one time and said, you know, Herod's going to get... I ain't worried about Herod. Go tell that fox, but... My reins also instruct me in the night season. Where did Jesus go in the night season? He went to the mountain to go pray to God. I have set the Lord always before me. You can never say that. Only Jesus can say that. He is my right hand, strength. I shall not be moved. You know, Satan tempted him and Jesus remained faithful. Jesus said, I could have called legions of angels and he never did. The Bible says he was to be dumb before, as a lamb before the shears. So as he stood before Pontius Pilate, as he stood before Herod, he didn't open his mouth. Therefore, my heart is glad. I mean, think about what Jesus is glad today about all of us that do and have followed him. He was pleased with 11 disciples. He said he loved John, the beloved. And my glory rejoices. Imagine Jesus' glory rejoicing. My flesh also shall rest in hope. What? He ain't going to keep me in that tomb. Imagine Jesus on that cross thinking as he's agony. You ain't got it. You guys down there, you're going to be sorry one day. You know, I love you. I'm doing this for you. And you can't keep me on this cross. And then thinking that as they put him in that tomb, you know, stone's going to roll away. He ain't going to keep me. He told the disciples, you're going to weep now, but you're going to rejoice. For thou wilt not leave my soul in hell. Again, that's not David. David did not go to hell. It's only one other person that this psalm talks about. Where could Christ take your sins if he didn't go to hell? Well, it was the blood. Yeah, it was the blood. Okay. But where does a sinner go? Hell. Where do you get the keys of death and hell? You think Satan came walking up to him? Here, Jesus. No. Neither will thou suffer thy Holy One to see corruption. Jesus' body did not rot, it did not stinky. You know the Pope's bodies are stinky and rotted? You know Muhammad's body was stinky and rotted? You know Nelson Mandela's body is going to be stinky and rotted? And Monday is going to be stinky. You're going to hold your nose in. I'm just going to say, because I'm just out of respect, but there's a place down here in Florida where they had a body that was dead in the house. I'm just using this as an illustration. I don't mean no disrespect, but it was the neighbors that called the police because of the stinking. That will show me the path of life. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. In thy presence is the fullness of joy. That's Jesus. Verse 11 becomes totally Jesus after he went to hell and after he didn't see corruption. He becomes the path of life. Listen, what did Paul say today about the resurrection? If there was no resurrection, eat, drink, and be married, we shall die. After the resurrection, because of the resurrection, was a slave. After the resurrection, the presence is fullness of joy. After the resurrection, thy right hand, there are presence forevermore. There you go. You have hell, and you have the resurrection, and you have Jesus in turn, the last few verses. And that's all that needs to be said. Anybody that says that Jesus did not go to hell, you're wrong. You need to repent. You need to plead the blood of Jesus, 1 John 1:9, or you're going to stand before Jesus, and he's going to call you a liar. Have a good day. We're done.
Consider all the worlds thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art! How great thou art! Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art! How great thou art! And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in, that on the cross, my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin.